All right, peeps, welcome back again to Grown Up Show and Tell. And today we have another unboxing, and this is an oldie but goodie figure. This is the NECA quarter scale Batman, Batfleck figure from Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice. And we're gonna do a quick unboxing and review. So there's the side of the box. Oh, see? Pictures of the figure. Back of the box. Okay. Alright. Includes two pairs of hands, batarangs, grapple gun with two tips. Alright. More pictures of the figure. Alright. And, as they say, let's get the bad boy out of the box. Alrighty. Got him out of the box. And I gotta tell you, looks awesome. 18 inches tall. And for the price, right? $100 plus shipping. That's how much they were at retail, $100. So I got it brand new in a box. And looks amazing. I mean, for the price, it looks amazing. I mean, as far as a face, he does remind me of Batfleck. And it's my favorite. Batfleck is my favorite version of Batman. So yeah, like I was saying, Ben Affleck's Batman, or the Snyderverse Batman, is my favorite Batman. Then after him is Christian Bale, and then Michael Keaton. Well, I guess you could say Christian Bale and Michael Keaton have a tie. So yeah, Christian Bale and Michael Keaton have a tie. And so yeah, there's the accessories. The two other hands to put his batarang and his grapple gun. But I'm just gonna leave those in the box. You know, I'm not really gonna posing this figure or playing with this figure or do an articulation test for you for the video. No, I'm just gonna have him like this. And I'm never really gonna touch him again. He's just gonna be for display. You know, I never got the Hot Toys. Yeah, I never got the Hot Toys version because, well, I just didn't like it. I didn't like it. I like the Batman, the Snyderverse Batman, and but I haven't picked up many of the Batfleck collectibles. But then the NECA one, I was like, yeah, I've been eyeing it for years because it came out a while ago. You know, came out years and years ago. Let's see. I guess, I don't know. There's no date on the box. You know, so. Well, anyway, the movie came out 2016 and the figures, you know, came out pretty soon around the movie came out, I guess. But, you know, at least 5 years ago. So, very happy with the figure. Let's do a 360. But yep, too bad we never got an 18-inch armored Batman from NECA. But oh well. Let's do some side-by-side shots now with the other Snyderverse NECA figures I have. So here we have them next to the NECA quarter scale BVS figure, or Man of Steel figure actually. And comparing the two, you see that the Batman figure is taller. Pretty cool. I was hoping they'd be similar size. They never did a BVS version of that figure. So these will have to do. These will have to work. They look great together. So, as far as Snyderverse movies rank goes, dang, that's a hard one. I'd have to rank them Man of Steel, my favorite. And BVS, my second favorite, not the theatrical version, okay? Not the version that came out in the theaters of Batman vs. Superman, no. The Ultimate Edition, the Ultimate Cut is the one. The one that's 3 hours long, okay? That one is just epic, Batman vs. Superman. You know, Superman lost to Batman. Batman beat Superman because, you know, Superman was holding back. He didn't really want to kill Batman. Yeah, like I was saying, Superman didn't really want to kill Batman, okay? And Batman, you know, he was trying to kill Superman. That's, you know, so Superman was holding back, okay, in that movie. Plus, Batman had kryptonite, okay? So yeah, you know, that's why he beat him. And, you know, because, you know, if Superman wanted to kill him, he would have done it, you know, instantly. But that didn't happen, so. And, but yeah, so then, finally, of course, Zack Snyder's Justice League is number 3 of my favorite, you know, superhero movies. Yeah, my 3 favorite superhero movies. Man of Steel, number 1. Batman vs. Superman, number 2. And the new Zack Snyder Justice League. My 3 favorite superhero movies. I think number 4 would have to be Logan. Alright, so, so yeah, they look awesome together. And let me just, get another NECA Snyderverse figure. Alright, be right back. Alright, so now we have the NECA come on. Okay, there you go. NECA black suit version from Man of Steel. And yes, he wore the black suit in Man of Steel. And it was in the dream sequence scene when Zod was talking to him, talking to Clark. So, and I'm also pretty impressed with this figure. And those stands, by the way, that I'm using for these, yes, I prefer them to have stands. Okay, they're Kaiser stands. Okay, Kaiser stand, K A I S E R, and from Amazon. You can get them from Amazon. Kaiser doll stands, and I got the black version. They have a white version as well, but I like the black version because they don't stand out. See, so that's what I use for all my 18-inch NECA figures. But yeah, this figure is awesome. It came in a black box. All right, and freaking amazing. So yeah, black suit is awesome. Black suit Superman is awesome, but I prefer red and blue. All right, and I'll be right back. All right, guys. So right here we have all three figures next to each other. They look amazing, and I just wish they would have done an armored Batman, but that's okay. Maybe in the future they'll make armored Batman, and maybe a tactical suit. I like the tactical suit that was in Justice League. That's awesome too. And do I care about the rest of the Justice League? Well, with the Snyder cut, I think all the characters were better. I liked Cyborg, the Flash. I liked them much better. They were more throwaway characters in the Joss Whedon version. But in the Zack Snyder version, I liked them much, much better. I want to see a Cyborg movie. Hopefully they do that. Wonder Woman was also better in this time around. she was more, yeah, she was just, you know, way more fierce, more warrior-like. That's what I like. Okay. I didn't care for Wonder Woman, the original movie. I never cared for Wonder Woman, but in the Zack Snyder cut, that was awesome. Or she was awesome. Batman was also way much better in the Snyder cut. In the last one, he was more wimpy. Joss Whedon made him more wimpy. But I liked him in Snyder cut. He was more of the leader, more take charge. And even though he didn't have superpowers, he did great. He held his own. Aquaman was better. He wasn't so dumb. Yeah, like I said, I like Aquaman better too, because Aquaman was kind of, like another funny whatever, who cares about him type of character, like the Flash, in the Joss Whedon version. But Snyder cut, I liked Aquaman much better, and he was also more fierce, more of a fierce warrior like Aquaman. On Aquaman the movie by itself, freaking awesome movie. I'd say that's, dang man, maybe that should make my top five. after Logan, you know, Aquaman. I really, really, really like that movie. So, you know, also, but yeah, I mean, you know, everything was better in the Snyder Cut. And I really, really like that movie. And if they do an IMAX release, I'm definitely gonna go. I saw it twice. Like I said, 4 hours I thought was too short. Or 4 hours didn't feel like 4 hours to me. And I wanted more. So I was very happy. And I hope we get a sequel. And if not, I'll be happy with what we got. You know. So, anyway, so I just wanted to show and tell my new Batfleck figure, and thank you guys very much for watching. Thank you for the support. Have a great day.